thank you, you are too kind. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to introduce myself. I am Charles Dickens, renowned author, writer extraordinaire, and of course, your humble servant. I shall begin today's reading of A Christmas Carol. Marley was dead to begin with, there could be no doubt of that.
Hey, what are you doing?
Hey, who are you?
This is our show.
Yeah, we've been rehearsing all week. What's the big idea?
Your show, my dear little friends, I assure you, I am the famed, prestigious, and illustrious writer Charles Dickens, and this is indeed my show,
Miss Drama Teacher.
Miss Drama Teacher!
Now, kids, this isn't how we rehearsed it, is it?
But he's stealing our lines!
Yeah, we're the storytellers here!
He can't just barge in here and take over like this.
Oh, dear Mr. Dickens, we're honored to have you. It's just they're playing different storytellers today.
Well, who the Dickens do they think they are? It says right here, A Christmas Carol by Charles Dickens, yours truly.
I wonder if we might ask you a favor.
This story is all about generosity. Of course, I will grant you a favor.
Well, we want to do it our way!
Yeah, we want all the kids to play the part and want everybody to be a part of the show.
Oh dear, that's a little unusual.
And we want everybody to sing Christmas Carol with us.
So everyone can have a good time.
After all, it's Christmas, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, isn't it?
Very well then, in the spirit of the season, perhaps you should take your...
My what?
My seat.
Yes, of course. Look like kids.
And the rest of you? As I was saying, Marley was dead.
Excuse me, Mr. Dickens.
Patience, patience. What is it?
There's a great deal come before that, sir.
Well, how do you think the story should begin?
On Christmas Eve.
Snow was falling everywhere.
Kids are throwing snowballs.
People are putting up Christmas trees.
Hanging the mistletoe.
And buying presents.
And hurrying home to get ready for
Christmas Day!
So, you're on Christmas Day off again this year, do you? It would be ever so nice of you to grant it to me. All my children and my dear wife will make them very happy, sir.
Very well. I'll think about it. Now back to work.
Suddenly, there was a cheerful voice.
Merry Christmas, Uncle Scrooge.
Bah, humbug.
What do you have to be cross about?
This Christmas that you love so much is robbing me blind. No one pays their bills. No one pays their rent.
Uncle, show yours now.
I lose money every Christmas, and it takes me half the year to make it up. Just ask him. Crash it over there. He's planning to steal a day's wages for this Christmas foolery.
Oh, hello, Mr. Cratchit. Merry Christmas to you.
Don't say it. Not under my roof.
I can't ask you for Christmas to help.
No, I'll be too busy doing his job and mine as well.
Well, change your mind.
I won't. Good day to you.
I asked you last year, and I'll ask you again next year. Maybe something you'll accept. Say Merry Christmas to your family, Mr. Cratchit.
You're very kind, sir.
Next came two unsuspecting people, Mary and Glee.
Merry Christmas, ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas, one and all!
Mrs. Scrooge, we hear you lend money for the poor.
Just half a shilling will feed a family.
Are there no prisons, no workhouses?
But the children, sir.
Are there no orphanages?
It's a very cold winter. Some of the poor among us may die without our help.
That is no business of mine. Good day to you.
Merry Christmas, sir.
Humbug. What are you doing?
If you please, sir, it is my quitting time, sir.
And you leave right at the minute? You expect me to give you a whole day? You can't give me a minute?
I'll come early the morning after, sir.
See that you do.
Again, Scrooge heard a cheerful sound.
Carolers from right outside his window. It sounded as if the whole town was singing, God rest ye merry gentlemen.
So,
The fog and frost hung about Scrooge's old house like a mournful ghost as he made his way to the front door.
Old Scrooge once had a partner named Jacob Marley,
but he had been dead for 7 years now.
Scrooge didn't miss Marley or even think about him.
But for some reason, this night,
Scrooge looked at his door knocker and saw Marley's face.
Marley? Oh, you must be getting old, Scrooge. There's no face on that knocker.
No.
Yikes! It's not good. Ha, poo, a
now there was a portrait of Jacob Marley that hung in Scrooge's bedroom.
Now there was a man who knew how to keep Christmas. Well, what was it you used to say, Jacob? Christmas is a horse used from every man's pocket every year. How true, how true.
Maybe the door knocker didn't frighten him.
Humbug.
Maybe the darkness didn't spook him.
Bah!
Maybe the shadows didn't scare
him. Ha!
But he double locked his door just the same.
Come, blessed sleep, come.
At last, Scrooge drifted away, and it seemed a choir of angels sang him to sleep.
Glad to hear it. You
will be haunted by three spirits. Expect the first when the first bell tolls one. Look to see me no more. Remember what has passed between us.
As all these terrible and troubling images fell away, Scrooge crawled into bed and fell into a deep, deep sleep.
Little did he know, little did he dream of the Christmas that was soon to come.
so bad to make a profit to improve one's standing?
That's all you really care about. I must return this to
you. No, Bill, no, Gaia.
No more! I want to see any more!
I told you, Scrooge! These are the things that have been! They are what they are!
I can't bear it! Take me back!
Very well, Scrooge. Take my hand. Goodbye, Master Scrooge. I shall not come again.
And again, Scrooge began
to sleep well.
Blind beggars walk and blind men see.
Why is everyone frowning?
It's Christmas. When do we eat, Mother? Can we start with the pudding?
Honey, Tim, you know very well the pudding comes after. Martha, Peter, set the table.
Ooh!
Why is poor small bird? What's everyone going on about?
It's time for the pudding, and Mrs. Cratchit is very nervous.
Why, it's as big as a bread basket.
Hey, as big as a house!
It's as big as me!
Merry Christmas to us all, my dears. God bless you.
God bless us, everyone.
Spirit, tell me if Tiny Tim will live.
I see a vacant place at the table.
No!
Time will tell if nothing changes in the future.
So it can be fixed when you change the future?
Another toast.
A toast to Mr. Scrooge, founder of the feast.
Founder of the feast, indeed. How can you toast to such a stingy, honest, hard of feeling man?
My dear, it's Christmas Day.
I'll toast to Mr. Scrooge because it's Christmas. I'm sure he and his money are having quite a holiday.
Take me away, Spirit.
Will you turn your back again, Scrooge? Will you ever look and see what is before you?
I see poor Tiny Tim.
Look around you, man. Tiny Tim is one of many.
But are there no charities, no foundations?
No prisons, no workhouses, no orphanages?
Please, please.
Once again, in the final time, Scrooge heard the bell strike.
Dong!
One! Thank you.
Whoa, what is this? It's a churchyard. I see that well enough.
It was overgrown with grass and weeds. The spirit stood among the graves and pointed down to one.
Before I look at the name on the stone, tell me, are these the shadows of the things that will be or can't be changed? Can I change them?
Still the spirit pointed.
Whose name has been chiseled there?
It says Ebenezer Scrooge!
As the words fell from his lips,
the ghost of the future began to fade away.
Oh no! No! Don't go! Hear me! I'm not the man I was! I will honor Christmas in my heart! I will live in the past, present, and the future! Hear me, Spirit! I will change!
It may be hard to believe, but the next day the sun came up, and the event was quite unremarkable. Past, present, and future seemed totally interested. The world went about its way as ever. But the only difference from all the other days was simply that it was Christmas. From the local chapels, one could hear people sing Joy to the World.
Rich and poor, the very same.
love you and had a merry time.
Fred, there you are, my favorite nephew. What a good handshake you have there. Here, shake the other.
At last, we came to the house of Bob and Mrs. Cratchit.
Ding dong!
Why, thank you. That was quite effective. I noticed you're very good at bells. Let's do it again, just for fun.
Ding dong!
Goodness, goodness, genius, all of you.
Whoever could it be?
I don't know, dear. Mr. Scrooge.
Bob, Lady Cratchit, how well you both look. I mean, you're making merry just because it's Christmas Day, of course. I came to tell you that I will not be standing here any longer. Therefore, I am giving you a raise. Yes, yes, a raise, a raise.
Mr. Scrooge?
Yes, what a nice surprise. Flesh and blood, heart and soul. Just like you, Tiny Tim. Just like you. Oh, heaven bless me.
God bless us, everyone. God bless us, everyone. Everyone.
God bless us, everyone!
Thank you. yard with all of them. She has taken her lunch break. She has taken her afternoons and her evenings from her family. So again, please give all of them a round of applause. On behalf of all of the staff and the faculty here at West Clayton Elementary School, we appreciate you sending your best that you have at home every day to us so that we can help educate your children and send them back to you. Thank you for giving us your best.
But said, I can't thank you enough for sending your children to us every day. It's such an honor to be able to serve them. I just want to thank you all for coming out. Thank you for supporting our school. Thank you for supporting your kids. And this is what it's all about. This is why we, this is school. And this is wonderful. And I'm very proud to be part of it. As you leave, we do have plenty of pizzas left over. If you are interested in a pizza, you can stop by.